We discovered that most of the people who have developed the new technologies that you'll learn about in the next few days, new methodologies, don't know about each other. And that's one of the reasons we're here today. They don't know how many people are doing this. And when I went out to do this research, I actually didn't think I'd find people who had real, sustainable methodologies worked out that weren't going to fall apart in the crunch. And what I discovered was all these different groups were doing the same kinds of things, but they'd never heard of each other. Some of them had read people like Alan Savory's books, and a lot of them had never heard of them. But they were doing the same kind of thing. So this is one, as a historian, I can tell you, this is one of those, these are ideas that are coming from the bottom up. These are ideas whose time has come. As a historian, I'll tell you, this is how cultural, social change happens. When everybody starts getting the same idea, you know you're onto something. And this is what keeps me going, how many people are just doing this, but also in a lonely way and cut off and not knowing how many other people are doing it. And the other thing I want to really emphasize is look where these ideas are coming from. They should be coming from the bottom down. The bottom up, not the top down. And the bottom up means not from governments, not from universities, and I'm sorry to say, in most cases, not even from environmental NGOs. They come from regular people, local people, who are motivated to figure out new ways to do things because they have to.